Okay. Sorry about that. I will try to not do that quick enough to glitch it out. But anyway, back in Darkroot Garden. And we're human now, and I'm going to try to get through this area without aggroing anyone. I have to aggro this last guy, but one stone giant is much easier than 10 stone giants. Look at this. Okay. Wow. I believe that hit me. There we go. Take a break for a little bit. Just do a little jog. Wait for it to run out. I'm going to probably have to switch up my shield for this next boss. Yep, I thought it was going to be out. Stone shield for my troubles? Alright, let's see what shield has the best magic. So it is that wooden shield. And I'm mid-rolling. Probably gonna need that, so might as well just fully own mid-roll. Alright. There's a witch. Witch Beatrice. I might as well wear the old witch's ring and kind of like solidarity or whatever. But yeah. Witch Beatrice, you know, we'll learn more about her or whatever. But she also braved the abyss, much like Artorias. So, this where the moonlight butterfly. You know, moonlight is associated with magic. I am not hitting. Whoa, how did... Oh my gosh, I thought I dodged. How did half of their health go away? Well, here's the other half. Weird. I'm gonna have to check the footage again. Oh, I guess they're just the soul spear which Beatrice uses. That does a lot of damage. Thanks, Beatrice. I'll see you later. I'll find your stuff later. Yeah, down there is where we saw this before. So yeah, this is the big tower, and we should check what's up it. Oh, we should also look at what the soul of the moonlight butterfly says. Soul of the mystical moonlight butterfly, which flitters in the Darkroot Garden. Special beings have special souls. The butterfly's soul is the creation of Seath the Scaleless, used to acquire huge amount of souls. We'll be saving all the boss souls, so we can at least try to get some boss weapons. But Seath the Scaleless, we know about Seath the Scaleless. Seath the Scaleless was one of the main characters in the original story. He was a scaleless dragon, and he betrayed his own kind and helped Gwyn, Nito, and the Witch of Izalith defeat the ancient dragons that were everlasting. They could last forever. Yes, obviously, but they were immortal. They're immortal due to their scales. So dragon scales have a very, mystical kind of relevance in this story. But anyway, Seath the Scaleless has quite an interesting story, and what happens with him and Gwyn after they find the dark souls, or the souls of the fire, the great Lord souls. And yeah, Seath apparently has been looking into the art of soul, manipulation, and has created a huge moonlight butterfly. Watchtower Basement Key and the Divine Ember and a Homeward Bone for good measure. And a wooden statue that looks exactly like Andre. I think it's just meant to kind of indicate that he's a blacksmith. So like this part of the game isn't like fully as it was intended. It was meant to be that, all the blacksmiths looked like this. Andre was a special blacksmith and he had special ties to Gwyn, etc., etc. A lot of that story went away, as described in the Designworks interview. I guess they just wanted to keep this here so that it looks like, so you understand that this is a blacksmith or whatever. But no other blacksmiths in the game look like Andre. I mean, we have Ricker, we'll have Vamos, we'll have the giant blacksmith, we'll have different people, and none of them look like Andre. So I'm not really sure what, they fully intended with, like if it's just, oops, we didn't include everything in the game, or if they're like, yeah, we have it make some sense. I don't know. We're gonna go back. Instead of using Homeward Bone, I'm gonna try to just grab that soul in the beginning of this area. So that I don't have to come back here. Well, I will have to come back to Darkroot Garden. Well, I mean, technically, I could go and buy the Crest of Artorias. I probably can get up to 20,000 souls here quite easily. But at this point in the game, I have no need to rush that part of it. And, so I will come back in a normal time. And we'll just take these guys out one by one. The problem with killing him earlier is just that, and grabbing this soul, is that they're always around, and so every time you're trying to run in, they always come after you. It's just an unnecessary complexity that we didn't need to do. So, yeah, let us go back and do some last minute things with Andre, and then we can start the next part of the recording, which will be concerned with taking care of loose ends and then taking out the gargoyles, which is really the first Dark Souls boss. Oh, I forgot that I'm still over encumbered when I don't need to be. I'll take care of that. Oh, we didn't read the Divine Ember as well. That's something we should probably read. Of course I'm gonna miss something, so let me just check. No, we read all that. Read all these things. Got all that. Alright. Ember required for weapon ascension. Divine embers are property of the church and intended for divine blacksmiths. Ascends plus 5 to a divine weapon. Divine weapons are used for undead hunting, used against undead and the pawns of necromancers. We'll come across necromancers later, but the necromancers bring back the skeletons, and so they're trying to just. Divine does particularly strong damage to undead, obviously, and also it will make it so that you can permanently kill these skeletons. Which is a cool thing. We did get the Watchtower key. So we could go down and. Let's click thinking. Okay. We could go down and try to fight Havel. But I feel like I want to do a whole nother. I'll probably do that when I come back through Blighttown, through the Valley of the Drakes. And just do that whole section out there. I'm not going to worry about it right now. But let's go back to Andre. Let's level up this Uchi to plus 5 so that we can take out the gargoyles without any issues.
My, that's a rare ember you have there. I've seen one of those before. It's the ember of a divine blacksmith. Might you consider leaving that with me? I could produce divine weapons with a flame such as that.
Sure. What am I gonna do with it?
Well, thanks for that. You've made a fine decision. You soon shall see.
Alright, let's see. Well, let's buy. I think it's 5. Oh no, it might be more than that. Because we've. We get 7. See if anything new to say.
This is the old church. It was abandoned in favor of the church that you passed through. There are paths leading from here to two forbidden planes, Sen's Fortress and the Darkroot Garden. They attract all sorts of lunatics, no one as cultured as yourself. It's fine to be undead, but keep a level head, eh?
So there's Andre confirming what I was saying. The old church, the new church, and then the Sen Fortress, where we saw Sigmire, and obviously Darkroot Garden, which we've been in.
Sen's Fortress is an old proving grounds built by the ancient gods. It is the only route leading to the great Anor Londo. Of course, most fools can't even find their way into that fortified death trap. But they won't stop trying. Take that bumbling Sir Onion.
So, again, we have this notion of proving grounds. The gods built Sen's fortress. I don't think they built it originally for Anor Londo. I think Anor Londo got sealed off, and we'll see evidence of that later. And I think that they. Again, what god? I don't know. I mean, there are lots of different gods. So I don't know if it was Gwyn and his folk, but I think Anor Londo was sealed off after Gwyn left Anor Londo personally. And he, you know, he's obviously indicating that we're trying to ring the bells. We know we have to ring the bells, and then, you know, he's saying, then we can get to Anne Orlando, whatever. So people can't even figure out how to get into the darn thing. Well, obviously by ringing the bells will lead us to that part of the game, so.
I know little of the Darkroot Garden, although I've heard rumors of a divine blacksmith who resides there. Those who get stumped in the catacombs seek him for divine weapons.
Yeah, that was a little out of order. So yeah, basically just saying that there was a divine blacksmith in Darkroot Garden. While we found him, he's dead or turned to stone or whatever that was. And so we gave the ember to him. And then he indicates that the catacombs would particularly be good against divine, which is where the necromancers and the skeletons are.
I know little of them.
All right. So, here, if we had a green Titanite shard, you could see that we could go from Ujikatana 5 to Divine Ujikatana. I'm obviously not going to be doing that. Well, not obviously, but I'm not going to be doing that.
Don't get yourself. Neither of us want to see you go hollow.
I'll be fine, Andre. All right, so let us equip these souls, and we're going to just do a big level up here. Before we proceed to the next part of the game, but we have a fully leveled up weapon for this point in the game, and we're gonna get a lot of. I'm probably gonna get a little bit of vitality. Why do that? All right. Until next time.